Navigating the world as a beginner runner can seem like a really complex task. With such a sea of information and so many people doing so many incredible things online, it can be easy to feel like we're behind in our running, we're not doing enough, and we're not doing the right things. But as a beginner runner, it's important not to throw yourself in too soon and going too hard too early, because this can lead to risk of over-fatiguing and to injuries and all the bad stuff that's associated with running. So I've made this video to break running down into three simple stages that you can progress through as a beginner runner to make sure you're getting the most out of your training, to make sure you're progressing as much as possible in your running journey. So that being said, let's get straight into stage one. Now, stage one is all about building an aerobic base. So the way this would look is to keep your running to three simple runs per week. You're gonna perform two runs at a low heart rate or a low intensity, a conversational pace if you haven't got a heart rate monitor, and you're gonna do one interval training session. I wish I structured my training this way as a beginner runner. When I started running, I just wanted to throw myself out there. The motivation was high. I wanted to get out the door as much as possible. And every session I'd try and push myself, I'd always feel like I was running. But what that looked like in reality is I spent too much of my time at my threshold pace. And my threshold was very low because I was a beginner runner. I wasn't particularly fit and I wasn't getting the most out of it. But more importantly, I was over fatiguing myself and I was leaving myself at a really high risk of injury and not building that base that we need to get to as a beginner runner. So if I was going back and I was going into what I'm now calling stage one, what this would look more like is I'd do most of my running. So two runs of the three per week. You can add more if you want, but three runs initially is absolutely fine. Two of those runs would be low heart rate, conversational pace, slowing down when I need to, even taking walking breaks, which is absolutely fine to do as a beginner runner, to make sure that I was building a good foundation. I was building my aerobic capacity. I was building up my distance slowly, but I was keeping my heart rate down, not putting too much stress on my body and building fitness the right way. The other run per week I wish I did at the start was interval training. And this is where you're gonna start to see some speed gains. So an example of a beginner interval run would be to pick a 200 meter stretch and to run at say an 8 or 9 out of 10 effort for that 200 meter stretch, and then to rest for double the amount of time the rep takes. So if a 200 meter run in your interval session initially takes say 30 seconds, hold a rest for a minute. And again, if that's longer, if it's 40 seconds, you might choose to rest for 80 seconds. But make sure you're sort of fully recovered. Make sure you're breathing and your heart rate's come down a little bit so that when you start the next rep, you're feeling pretty fresh and you can put as much speed and as much effort into that next rep as possible. So there's three runs to be doing on stage one as a beginner runner. Two low heart rate, longer duration runs. So they might be longer distance, but they're gonna be longer in duration with a low heart rate. Taking time to walk if necessary, it probably will be to start with. And then one harder effort run where you're gonna perform reps, sort of 6 to 10 reps at about 200 meters, making sure to rest for double the amount of time in between those reps. This stage I'd imagine to start with, depending on what we talk about in stage two or three, should take about 4 to 8 weeks. But make sure you're really, really comfortable with these runs. Make sure you're able to hold zone two for longer without stopping. Make sure these intervals are slowly going up in distance or in reps. And then we can move on to stage two. So stage two is where we're gonna start to add threshold running. Or you might have heard this referred to as race pace running. It's gonna be the running we talked about earlier, the running I started with, where I was running most of my runs at a pace that was getting me out of breath. It was comfortable-ish, comfortable enough to hold for a fairly good amount of time, but still leaves you feeling fatigued and out of breath after you run. So stage two, we're gonna ramp up to 4 runs a week now. One run is still gonna be performed at the slow zone two pace. I think that's really important to take through the three stages. We're still gonna do our interval, although that's now gonna get a little bit longer in duration, or we're gonna add reps to that. So it might be 400 meter intervals now. It might be done for 8 to 10 reps. And then our remaining two runs are gonna be done at our threshold pace. So this is gonna be a pace where the heart rate's a little bit higher than it would be if we're doing our slow run. It's not gonna be quite as high as we're getting it to in the interval training, but it's gonna be somewhere in between, somewhere where it's a little bit uncomfortable, but you're able to sustain it for a little bit longer. And this is where you're gonna start to see your fitness gains come in. As you progress through stage two, hopefully you're able to hold that pace for a little bit longer. And you might even see that pace start to increase slightly. But this is gonna feel a little bit more like running. This is gonna feel a little bit more like what you're gonna be doing when we get onto stage three in a minute, where we start to talk about racing. But I think we don't want to rush into this threshold running. I see it all the time. And like I said, I was guilty of it. Everybody to start with just goes out at this pace where it feels like you're getting a bit out of breath because again, feels like what you're meant to be doing. But we're going to add this in slowly and build it up over time. Again, this will minimize the risk of injury, and this will allow us to get the most out of our training for stage two. So stage two might take 4 to 8 weeks, dependent on what you're aiming for in stage three, but make sure that threshold speed is either going up or the duration of those threshold runs is getting longer and longer before you move into stage three. So stage three is all about racing. So now we're seeing our fitness gains, we're getting fitter, we're ready to enter a race. And this isn't necessarily a case of trying to achieve the fastest time, but it's more a benchmark to show where we are with our fitness, where we've come on our fitness journey. So through your threshold running in stage two, you're gonna start to establish what sort of pace you can hold for what sort of time. And the race distance isn't really important here. You might be looking to do a 5K park run, you might even be looking to do a half marathon or even a marathon. The distance of race will obviously depend how long you stand each stage. So for example, a marathon training block is typically 16 to 20 weeks, and it's that long for good reason. So don't rush through stage one and stage two to get to the marathon in stage three. Take your time going through these stages, spend longer in these stages if your race distance that you're aiming for is longer. But we can use these race days as a benchmark of where we are with our fitness. We can have it as a culmination of all the hard miles that we've put in, but we can also look at it as a learning process. So you might find on your race day that your breathing felt great, that you're able to cover the distance with no problem, but you don't feel like you've got much speed in your legs. And that's great. That just means next time when you're going back through stage one and two, you might choose to add longer intervals or go faster on your interval sessions. Or you might find you felt really, really fast on the day, but you just started to drift off a little bit at the end. You didn't quite have the endurance in your legs. And again, that would mean adding a little bit more zone two training, trying to push those threshold runs up a little bit, trying to run for longer on your slow run days. Whatever it is, it's going to give you an indication of how your training's going, where you're doing really well and where you're lacking a little bit. And we can learn a lot from this so that we can improve our training for next time. But the culmination of stage three is to get a race done, review how it went, and try to alter your training accordingly for next time. There really simply is the three stages I'd be going through, from beginner runner all the way up to someone who's ready for a race, and then how I'd alter my training going forwards. So hopefully this gives you a little bit more of an indication of what sort of training you should be doing as a beginner runner, how it's going to be most effective, and what we can learn from our race day experience. Let me know if you found this useful in the comments. Let me know how your training's going and what you're training for. I'm always interested to hear. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you again in the next one.